first off, my name's Chachi. I'll be broadcasting with you tonight, and alongside me is my man, Piff. Piff, what's up, brother?
What's up, man? This is Piff coming at you with TWL Live 4x4 DDM tonight, and TDM tonight, actually. Looking at the number one ranked Xeno, 6-1, versus C1, an awesome team that we saw last time. Really, really dominate SD, and looking forward to some awesome competition tonight, actually. Not very familiar with Xeno, actually, but I'm sure from what I'm seeing just in the warm-up, they're going to give a good match.
Well, right now, Xeno is 6-1 on the TWL 4x4 TDM ladder, with significant wins over most of the teams. The closest they've had was against the Elite Spark Pack, I believe is what their name was, or something like that nature. But also, we've got C1. Last time, if you checked us out on our last UT3 broadcast, you saw that we showed the Chosen Ones playing C1 versus Silent Dragons with a very significant and dominant beat-in that they put on Silent Dragons, keeping less than 20 frags every map, and breaking 100 every map. So definitely is going to be an interesting matchup tonight. I'm just trying to get to the server myself. I'm having a bit of an issue.
Nice shots, nice. Well, I hope you get that worked out, because we're already seeing some good competition here in just the warm-up mode. Yeah, C1, you know, 99 veterans obviously showed that they still had some definite skills last time we were in this situation. Not really, like I said, familiar with Xeno as much, but what I'm seeing right here, the hit scan is off the charts by them. So that's going to be real interesting, especially in those wide-open areas in deck where you can just pick people off.
Most definitely tonight we have on the schedule to be played, we're going to be playing deck, Defiance and Fearfulness. Now, we saw, or most UT players out there know deck. I mean, this has been a remake after remake after remake. Just they put a whole different look, whole different skin on top of it most of the time. We've also got Defiance, which you will see as last time we showed C1. They did very well in Defiance, controlling those power-ups, controlling the timing of it, being critical, and getting that action going.
Absolutely, man. You know, that's really how they dominated a lot of the SDs, well, basically a lot of their maneuvers, because they were on top of those power-ups right off the bat. I mean, that first 82 seconds is critical, man. If you can't hold that 100 shield, it's going to get kind of hard to get there again if you have a good team that's going to time those power-ups correctly, as we saw last time. And I don't know what we're going to see tonight. It looks like it's shaping up to be pretty good. I think we're waiting on a couple players, though. Looks like somebody from Xeno's going to have to do a reboot. He should be back any minute. And are we still waiting on someone from C1, or are they going to go 3v3?
I'm not sure exactly, so it's like actually I'll have to check the server. Alright, well, while we're waiting to get this action away, we'll mention a few things that the UT community might like to hear about. Next weekend, Warfare of the Nations. If you haven't checked out the Warfare game type, pretty much is the love child of Onslaught and Assault. And pretty much we have the U.S. versus the Euros. That's right. Warfare community, zerofrag.com. That's the U.S. community against justwarfare.com. That is the European community. They are sponsored by multiplay.com, .co.uk. And we'll be doing a two-leg, pretty much a little mixer tournament there. Just kind of having some fun, getting some activity going on.
Yeah, really looking forward to that. I know both teams have been gearing up pretty well, practicing hard this week. I've been in touch with Dow. By the way, you know, anybody, you know, interested in UT3, always stop by www.zerofrags.com, I believe. That's correct, right, Chachi?
Yes, www.zerofrags.com. That is the U.S. community. If you're a U.S. Warfare player and would like to, you know, check out what the community's up to, go check them out over there. They seem the most active warfare community at the moment. Got tons of cool stuff going over there. Tons of people making a lot of custom maps come your way. So you'll be able to check out a lot more stuff if you're a little bit tired of the stock things that are showing up in UT3. So lots of good stuff coming from those guys.
Yeah, can't wait for that Snakebite map to go really get out of its beta phases and go live. I would like to see it on a couple of ladders, actually. You know, as a lot of people know, it's actually a remake of Frostbite, which was either the bane of your existence or one of your favorite maps ever, depending on what you played in UT2K4. So basically, I'm really looking forward to that. I think that they've got a couple of custom maps for download up there on Zero Frags. And just speaking to, speaking back to that situation with the UK versus US warfare competition match, I was speaking to Dow the other day and talked to Thunder earlier today, and they're still looking for anyone who wants to, you know, come in for the practice, always looking for good, you know, strategy tips and stuff like that. I know BGE is going to be getting in with them hopefully tomorrow. Me and Soz are going to go in there and do a little bit of strat stuff and kind of show them some things if there's something they don't know, if they need any help. And maybe we'll be able to, you know, work with them and get some play time in there. That'd be cool too. But I'm really looking forward to that match. I think it's going to be awesome. What do you think, Josh?
Oh, definitely. I mean, I think Warfare.com is taking it a lot more serious than, or not Warfare.com, but ZeroFrag.com is taking it a lot more serious than just Warfare. But we are going to be playing our first leg of the event on European servers. So next weekend will be the European servers we're playing on. So we're going to see what the ping difference is going to do in this vehicle-based game. But again, later next week, Europeans got to deal with it because we can't play on a U.S. server. So, I mean, it's going to be fun all the way around. It's something that they decide that they want to try to do, try to get a little bit more activity in the community, let people know, hey, Warfare is here, and they are, you know, wanting to get this started. So, you know, it's going to be good times all around. Win or loss, it's going to be a good time.
Absolutely, man. It looks like we're getting ready to be go live on this match, starting with Deck. For C1, we've got, looks like their A team, we've got Danimal, Nova, Apocalypse, one of my favorite players as always, and Hillary Duff, also a favorite, Nasty on the hit scan. And then on Xeno, we've got Solidus, Apostasy, Nuk, and Osiris. Excuse my pronunciation there, but it looks like they're getting ready to go live here in just one moment to start this match up.
Yes, everyone on the Xeno side has raided up except for Solidus, and we're just waiting for a few on the C1 side. Again, if you checked out the Silent Dragons versus C1 match, and if you didn't, that is up in our cash archive right now to go check out later on when this is done. You will see some raping at its best action. Apocalypse was called our man of the match during that time, where he definitely did some killing all night long. You also will see Hillary Duff in there, for example, in Shangri-La. Perfect work when it came to matching up those timings for catching things such as the jump boots and power-ups and such. So, I don't know, and when we talked to them afterwards, they said it was kind of just coincidence. They really weren't trying real hard to match the timings. But we're going to see if that same practice comes into play tonight, because, again, Xeno is 6-1 on the TWL44 TDM ladder. And right now, you know, C1's 1-1. So we're going to see how this goes. It should still be a really good matchup. This is a broadcast request coming in from Apostasy from Xeno, so we want to thank him very much for asking us to come out here and check this out.
Oh, absolutely. I'm looking forward to it. It could go either way at this point, man. You know, like I said, with the limited information I have about Xeno, I know that, well, like you mentioned before, that C1, very, very laid-back kind of play style. Absolutely doesn't really do a lot of power-up call-outs from what we've talked to APOC about. Just basically, you know, kind of goes with the flow and picks up the power-ups as it goes, and everybody knows the timings on their team, so they just kind of move well with each other, which I think is a really good way to have an awesome, awesome skill-level team, because then you don't have to worry about where somebody's going to be. You've got, you know, faith in your teammates. That's really one way you can come together and win matches that you really shouldn't win sometimes. And, you know, it's all about that team play, thus the TDM. You really can't be a solo player in this. You got to help out your guys. But I'm really looking forward to it. I'm hoping this goes live sometime here in a second, because, yeah, I'm kind of tired of looking at zero scores.
Well, okay, before this goes live, we want to remind you, if you have the IRC network or IRC installed on computer, check us out on the Game Surge network on IRC, #E-Rev. We will be taking your shout-outs live during the match, and we'll call them out in between rounds. You can catch me in there, E-Rev UT Chachi, as well as my boy Piff here, E-Rev UT Piff. So if you got your shout-outs, we'll try to get those out there to you during the match, and hopefully everyone enjoys this. Again, this is live, TWL 44 TDM, Clan Xeno UT versus the Chosen Ones. Xeno defending their number one spot in the TDM ladder at this moment. So definitely should see some good action come from them, as they are 6-1. Also, we want to remind you, if you're into any other games such as COD 4, tons of action coming your way. We're covering stuff all over the place with COD 4. We got a couple of live lands that we will be doing on location, doing a broadcasting with here coming up in the next month or so. So be sure you check out www.e-rev.tv to stay up on that news and to find out when your next cast is going to happen or the next game you're proud of.
Our first shout-out of the night comes from Zeno, actually. Apparently, Nock thinks he's very sexy, and he's someone's lover on the team. I'm not really sure which one. I'll have to go back and chat to see that.
I've also got a shout-out from Axis White Fang. Shout-out to all the EREV people. EREV kicks ass. So do you, White Fang. Thank you very much for checking us out. And hopefully you enjoy this match. It's all up to Zeno and the Chosen Ones tonight.
Goodness. Just waiting to see what's going to go on with this readying up. It looks like somebody's changing out their crosshairs, which of course is important. I mean, I know how DMers are very, very picky about their settings. Now, really, Deck, as everybody knows, the 100 shield placement is the same from 2004 as it is now. Changed a little bit from 99. This is actually more of a remake of the 99 map than anything else, with the goo rather than the lava. Basically, it was kind of a, you know, a throwback to that. And it looks like we're going live right now.
Nope, we had someone go, okay, I thought it said not ready. Yeah, it looks like we got the good luck, have funs coming out there. And we're just waiting for Danimal to come in there and ready up. So, yeah, it looks like we are going to have this happen. C1 versus Zeno match is starting right now. And I'm going to go ahead and grab onto somebody here real quick. And I'm on Osiris. As he goes up the ledge, he's going towards Sniper, throws out a couple of cores as he avoids a Sniper shot of a number of members of C1, backs up to pick himself a little bit more healthy, he's up to 100, going around to that rocket hallway, and in front of him he sees a member, but behind him barely avoids the goo, but the rockets come after him, and that was Apoc with the rockets and the kill on Osiris, so already got some action going on with that. I want to move around also to see what else we got. Let's get on Apoc real quick as he's holding next to the double damage area. Loading up some tri-rockets, just trying to see if he can catch someone coming around a corner. Again, he's looking down that rocket hallway, looking into the main room, and across the way, not finding a whole lot of action. He picks up that rocket ammo, and he moves around the side. No one's there either. He's just kind of going around, checking out, see where he can find the action at. Pimp, who are you checking out?
I'm checking out Apoc. See, what he's mainly doing right now, oh, nasty flak blast to the face, took Apoc down. Now, actually, Zeno had the lead there for a moment, but it looked like Solidus actually had a little bit of an accident with his flak cannon, brought that down to minus two on the Zeno versus C1, so 3-5 right now, that's C1 winning. Apoc is mainly just kind of camping that hallway for the rockets and the goo, making sure he can stay close to that double damage and that 30, and well, keep an eye on those thigh pads, because when somebody goes up there, it's kind of a risk you take getting sniped off of that top level. I'm down to Nova now, and he's actually running through the double D, fighting with a member of Zeno in the long hallway. He's taking some link spam, hiding out now next to the health pickups. Got the health pickups back up to 154. Looks like he's taking on some rocket fire from a member of Zeno. Already has the jump boots, jumps over the top of him, rocket in the head. It kills him down, so that's another kill for C1. See here. He's moving around the right-hand side to lift area. Got another member backing him up from C1. Looks like they're just kind of doing a triangulation of fire on Osiris. Nova killed Osiris right there. That's another kill for C1. It's 6-6 dead even across the board right now. Let's take it over to the Zeno side. Chachi, who are you looking at?
Let me see here. I'm looking around at Daniel, actually, at the moment from C1 there. Real quick, we understand that the video is running a little bit dark. We will get that checked out for you here in just a little bit. Nomadicus, if you could look at the hit escape, hit your settings, you should be able to change the brightness in-game there to help out with them on that. All right, I'm on Daniel as he's going out. Rockets loaded up, has a member of Zeno from him. Drops down, he's at 100 health. Picks up that armor as he goes up the lift, going towards Sniper Rifle. Sniper is not there from the pickup. Still, he's just kind of spamming the rockets around. Sees two members of Zeno from him. The rockets fly, taking out Nock with one set of rockets. He runs through towards the portal, runs through it, and holds up top. looking over the main room, goes into the center main room again, picking up a little bit of that Stinger ammo as he starts to run the Stinger. No one there. APOC is on a killing spree as he took Osiris out with a rocket. Let's get on APOC again really quick.
Which is
here.
Typical
again, he was
for
the
APOC.
Man of the match. Very typical, because right now it's 17-9 right now with C1 with the advantage. APOC holding off the side there, picked up a little bit of that shock ammo, told him down next to that rocket area, throws up tri-rockets, nothing to connect against, but he gets bounced around by a little bit of shock. Again, loading up some double rockets there, and no one really to hit off of right now. So it seems like every time I try to get to him, there's not a lot of action coming his way, but he's doing a lot of killing. But really quick apostasy with a rocket drops from above, takes him out of the game. So 11-17 right now. Piff, what you got going on?
Yeah, ended his killing spree right quick there, didn't he? I'm looking at Nock right now. He's throwing up some combos, trying to take out a member of C1, going for that double D. He's actually getting some flak spam down the hall. Nailed Hillary Duff with a shock primary. She's down over at the lift. Let's see here. Now they're going for the 100 shield, trying to camp that. Which obviously, both teams are really, really trying to stay on top of those power-ups. They know how absolutely important they are to winning a match. Nock gets the 50 shield, goes back up, only at 45 health right now, catching some stinger spam from a member of C1. Managed to get around the corner, throwing shock force down, trying to catch around the corner, blind shock combos. Kills Nova with a shock primary, but gets taken out immediately by Danimal Stinger. Now, I'm going to move on down to Solidus, actually, from Xeno, who's going to run through the link gun area, moving around to the double D, fighting with a member of C1, actually link taping him right now. Gets taken out from behind by Apocalypse with the Enforcer. God, it's humiliating in competition. But hey, you know, that's how it happens sometimes. Especially when it's APOC. So, who are you looking at, Chazzy?
I'm looking at Nock right now as he's running with a double damage in the flak ammo. He did just take Hillary Duff out. He's 10 kills for 6 death as another kill comes his way via the flak cannon. He's down in the bottom. He's around jump boots. Checks it out. Jump boots are not there. He's holding the sniper rifle in hand and trying to get himself a couple of shots there from below. He's kind of just staying down there going back and forth. Moves back towards the lift as he's camping that armor and waiting for it to come up. Maybe he realizes time is close. He is sitting with 100 health right now, though, so he's sitting pretty on the health. As he goes up top, just kind of going back and forth. Again, he's keeping an eye on this armor at the moment. No one at all is messing with him. And there he goes. Armor's up. Picks up a fresh set of shock. And Danimo goes out with a flat cannon shredding. So Nock goes up top, finally throws a core in the combo of the corner to see if he can catch anyone. No one there to catch. Finds a member of C1. Drops the bomb on. Hillary Duff starts a killing spree with a flat cannon. Goes around again. He picks up those jump boots and goes up high. He's at mid-level, holding around the double damage area. Flak in hand. Seems to be weapon of preference at the moment. So he goes out there spreading that flak around the corner, see if he can catch anybody. He's going down that center walkway, moving back up towards the flak spawn area. He's trying to back it off as he catches the member C1 down the bottom. That person running enforcers against him. They're both at the very top right now, trying to fight it out, but not dropping down low to see if he can catch someone else. And that was APOC going out the shock beam, but not going out very quickly. Score has turned around, though. It's 28-26 at the moment, with C1 leading right now. Nock, 13 kills, 7 deaths. Apostasy, 8 kills, 5 deaths. Osiris, 4-5. Saudius, 3-11. On the C1 side, we got APOC with 11-9. Hillary Duff, 6-7. Nova, 5-8. And Danimal is 4 kills with 7 deaths. Piff, what is up with you, man?
I think it's really important to note right now that I've been watching Hillary Duff for a few moments. She's really controlling those power-ups. She's gotten the jump boots 3 times in a row now, hit the second double D power-up. She obviously knows what's going to happen and when it's going to happen. Running her timing's good tonight. So that really could be critical in them actually bringing this back. They're only 5 kills down right now. Can still go either way. It's neck and neck between these two teams. She's actually just taken out by Solidus shot combo, blind combo around the corner. APOC just rode Nox, looks like Rocket. And Hillary with a full goo on member of Xeno, but didn't manage to get the kill. Must have the 100 shield up there. She actually moved up a portal, actually tossing goo, spamming it down the hallway towards Xeno, coming back up the main lift on the right-hand side, still with the goo, trying to get those full goo shots on people because they have like a 3 to 4 second kill rate. You can actually take out another player. It's a good strategy. You can take out another player of their team if they get too close to them. So spamming rockets now down the hall, getting surrounded, kills Apostasy, picks up the double D, takes it from him. Man, she is good at that. And moving down the far hallway towards the sniper area, it looks like. Now I'm going back to APOC. He's coming out from the top portal area, moving down the rocket hallway. Trying to spam some rockets, trying to get some spread action on those main openings, knowing that they're all up top. And Xeno looks like it's camping the... Looks like it's actually just camping the top, trying to get those sniper kills, take them out with the hit scan, which, I mean, is a perfectly legitimate strategy here, because, I mean, in deck, it's very easy to do that. APOC still spamming rockets through that main area, kind of getting some action from another member of Xeno, but he turned his back on him, which is a mistake with APOC. You really don't want to do that. This might be bad for him. Nope, but Osiris still gets taken out by Nova from Z1. So, who are you looking at, Chad?
I'm on Apostasia's moment. He says he's on the outside top of those ramps. Again, he's holding sniper rifle in hand. Now, it looks like a few people like to do this. Now, I've got to mention there, earlier C1 was in the lead by about a good 7 or 8 frags, but now they are down 7 or 8 frags. So, definitely, Xeno coming back and is starting to fill this map out and fill this team a little bit better. Apostasia with rockets in hand spans a couple of tri-rockets down to the bottom. As he sees member C1 run the stinger, tries to catch him on the lift, and that was Nova. He does catch Nova as Nova comes off the lift trying to avoid the rockets, but not quick enough. Possibly picking up some fresh shock there. He's sitting with 41 health, though, and he's going to have to watch out. He backs away, throws a combo, connects with that, picks up the jump boots. The escape is in hand as he goes up towards the bio area there. And he's
that was nice.
To see if he can catch another combo. Very close call for Apostasy. But, oh, tri-rockets knock him down to 3 health as he fights that member of C1. Starts to run the stinger. Desperation ensues, but that person goes out to another member of C1. As he's checking out that armor spawn, hoping that happens, but not quick enough as APOC from below takes him out with a flat cannon. We're going to move around on some other action real quick. I haven't looked at Osiris much. He's only 8-14 at the moment, but we're going to see what he's got. Also, there's 10 minutes left in this match. Scores 42-33 at the moment with Xeno with the lead there. So we're going to see if C1 can come back from it. Osiris playing around with his lifts, goes towards the rocket hallway, has flak in hand, and pulls out the shot, does connect with one shot. Combo from down the end. He misses the core, though. But APOC right next to it takes a combo hard against the side of the head. So
Insiris
right there next to the double D. But that double D is picked up by another member. That was Apostasy. Let's get on Apostasy as he runs a minigun. Double kill with a stinger as APOC goes down to it at the end of it. So Apostasy does have the double D at the moment. Shock in hand, throws out the cores, connects with a little bit of damage. Tries to avoid the sniper shot of that C1 member and the rockets. He also has the jump boots in hand. Pulls away, doesn't know it, but Daniel's right behind him with the flat cannon. 50-35, though, Xeno is starting to stretch this lead a little bit farther.
Yeah, they really are. What really needs to happen here for C1 is they've got to get back in a group kind of atmosphere. They got to get to backing each other up. What's happening right now that I'm seeing is Xeno is usually 3 men deep when they're facing like one guy from C1 a lot of times. And there's 2 guys on top of that 100 shield whenever it spawns. So all I'm seeing is Xeno grabbing the 100 shield. The only thing I've seen C1 pick up for the last like probably 5 minutes has got to be the 50 shield packs and the 30, the 5 pads. I mean, really, that's got to change in order to stay competitive in this match. I'm looking at Knock right now. Kills Hillary Duff with a blind rocket from around the corner. Actually, really making good use of those jump boots, hopping around the map, and goodness gracious, 3 rocks in the face of Danimal as he comes down to try and take him out, avoiding some massive Q shots there, and still doing well. I can't say it's spam with the rockets because he's connecting with 90% of them, so... still finding the member of C1. Looks like he's going to go out to the main area where the goo traps are. Almost falls in it, but actually does a good backwards double dodge around there. Spamming some combos up top. Kills Osiris around the corner. And who are you looking at, Chach?
I'm looking at Hillary Duff at the moment. Hillary is she's holding next to the bottom. There it has. Finally does pick up some shields so they can start to try to watch that. Picks up 50 more health as she goes up the lift. Flat cannon in hand. Finds a member Xeno in front of her there and is just kind of spamming the flak out there. He's doing circles and Osodius did connect with one sniper shot but was not enough as Hillary Duff takes him out with a little bit of that flak shredding. Looks in front of her, sees 2 members of C1. Starts to throw the cores down there. See if she can get a combo. She backs away from the action. Kind of feeling a little bit hesitant to run forward there. Right now, Xeno has 64-38. They are locking down this Chosen One team. The Chosen Ones might not be as chosen as they thought, other than chosen to lose for this particular match. I'm going to get on Knock real quick because he is at 24 kills with 8 deaths at the moment. He is just doing a phenomenal job out there. He's holding the top area there. And oh, it takes a sniper shot, gets knocked back. He's down to 72 health. He looks down at the bottom of those lift to see if there's anything. Sets up some tri-rocks and throws them up to the bottom. Does find a member C1 in front of him there, again, with rockets in hand. Looks like he's trying to do some damage, but just can't quite do it. Is that C1 member is dancing all around him at the moment.
And that's APOC, man. That's how he plays.
He's playing games with that lift, that's for sure. But Knock is not afraid to move away from there. It looks like he likes being able to stay next to there, stay next to those two 50 amps, or 225 amps, and that health pickup as he picks up the 100 shield as well. So he's sitting with 100 shield and 100 health. Goes up top towards the sniper area and tries to avoid all the sniper shots coming after him. Throws up a core, does connect some hard damage against member C1. And it was Nova in the corner, tries to come out and get a shot, but Knock right there with the combo.
Ooh,
double kill
on Rampage.
Nova again. Nova double kill on the same player as soon as it spawns. Perfect timing for those combos. So you can't ask for much better at this moment. The score is 67-44.
Yeah, Knock just went on a rampage, man, making an awesome use of those jump boots. I really have not seen that level of play with the jump boots in this map. He's actually been able to escape quite easily. Nails Hillary Duff in the face with some rockets, facing another member of C1, but he's got them cornered because he's got two more members of his team with him. Kills Hillary Duff with another blind rocket, it looked like, because he fired it so fast. Fighting two members of C1, kills Danimal with a rocket to the face. Goodness gracious, man, this guy is just ridiculous. Now, I'm moving on to somebody from C1, see what they've got going on. They really need to start controlling those pickups better if they're going to turn this around. Looking at Hillary Duff right now, just took a full bio goo to the face. Let's move on for a moment. So, Apocalypse, always one of my favorites, taking some rocket spam towards the sniper area up top. I guess member of Xeno, actually, who's down by the double D, and looks like he's well shielded, not really taking much damage from that last shot primary, but combo from the back, kills Osiris, puts another one on the board for C1. He's now trying to take out, looks like, another member of Xeno up top, but he's running into three guys. He's got one on the top in the main room who can snipe him easily. He's got two in that rocket hall, in the far goo hallway. Who are you looking at right now, Chachi?
I check on Nova as he just took out Osiris in the Black Cannon. Nova C1, he's 12-24. He's in a bit of a fight at the moment. Zodius, though, goes out to the Black Cannon as well. We've got a little bit less than 4.5 minutes left in this map. And C1's got, 25, 26, 27 kills. 26 kills as Osiris goes out again to the Flat Cannon. So C1's going to really have some work to make up to do. The last 4 minutes of this. But Knock is just not having it. He's going 30 kills and 8 deaths at the moment. But he hasn't gotten a kill in a little bit. Apostasy takes out Nova. So Nova going out there. We're going to move around and, again, let's get on Knock. I mean, he's the one who's been really been doing a lot of the raping this moment. He's 30-9, picks up a set of rockets, goes out in the main room around that Link spawn area there, looks off towards the double damage. A member C1 did pick up the double damage. I want to see if I can find out who that was real quick and get on them. That's Apostasy running dual enforcers with a double damage. But Apostasy goes out to the stinger of C1, so another member of C1 does have that double damage at the moment. That's Sodius. Sodius, again, with double enforcers in hand, takes Nova out with a double damage, double enforcers as Nova was trying to pick up some rockets. Sodius picking up a little bit of health. He's at 22 health at the moment, and the double damage has ran out, so he pulls out that sniper rifle, fires down towards that flag spawns. He saw a member of C1 down there. Score 88-56 as Hillary Duff gets taken out by Knock off camera. And I don't think C1's going to be able to come back from this. There's only 3 minutes left. They're going to have to do some major raping to be able to come back.
It's going to have to totally turn around for them at this point. I mean, Knock is doing such a good job at keeping his health up, even after he gets injured. He knows when to run. He knows how to escape. He's using those jump boots to his advantage. Solidus actually is backing him up right now. C1's just, it seems like they're just kind of spread out tonight and not really having, well, they may be bringing their A game, but just been kind of getting a little dominated by this Xeno team. And I really just don't know what to say. I was expecting a much closer competition on this. When they started pulling out, five ahead, I was actually very surprised. Double damage is up, though, and Solidus is right next to it. It looks like Xeno's going to get it again, but I don't know. There's a lot of combo spam coming out of that bio pickup area. Kills Nova from behind, just completely missed the blind spot when he ran by. Actually, it might be C1's double damage. Are you watching this, Chouch?
I am definitely watching this action. I mean, there was a big fight going on for that double damage. And it's still sitting up at the moment, so no one's been able to grab a hold of it. I'm going around this map to see if I can find someone who's willing to take it in hand. And APOC didn't have it. Excuse me. Hillary, yeah, I believe that was APOC that had it. I'm sorry. It came off really quick there. APOC taking Osiris out with dual enforcers. No, actually, just single
enforcers. And Apostasy currently having it.
Apostasy has it. Let's get on Apostasy real quick. Posse with Singer in hand, but the double damage is running out. Posse running 23 kills, 18 deaths. Not too shabby. He picks up a little bit of shock. He's only sitting with, oh, never mind, sitting with zero health as he goes out to a set of dual enforcers. Scoring 99-65, last minute and a half. Definitely Xeno has locked this up. We're going to watch Nock for the very last hit. It looks like for this round, he's going to be considered the man of the match for this round.
Yeah, most definitely. Man, I have never seen this many dual enforcers running around the map. Every 3 seconds is a dual enforcer kill. That is hilarious. Basically, we got Nock jumping down, camping the 50 shield as he's been doing all night. Oh my goodness, it's a crazy sniper shot from around the corner on takes out Osiris. He's actually fighting another member of C1 right now, still staying close to that 50 shield in those jump boots as he loves them. I was surprised. Hillary usually likes, you know, doing the up and down thing more, but Nock apparently is into it too. And then it looks like Xeno yet again got the double damage. So 30 seconds left in the match. Current scores 103-69. Quick rundown. It's Nock with 34, best net in the entire match. Apostasy with 25, Solidus with 23, Osiris 21, looking pretty even across the board there. Another story altogether with C1. Looks like Apocalypse, of course, is the leading man. Nova second with 21, Apocalypse 26, Hillary Duff 16, Danimal 7. 5 seconds left in the match. It's tied up now, man. It's all Xeno. All Xeno. So 106-72, final map score on that. And Nock is our MVP, I believe.
For this particular round, he is 34 cores. Kills and 15 deaths for Nock. Apostasy 27-22. Soldius 24-28. Osiris 21-23. Danimal on the C1 only 28. I don't know. The screen came up on me real quick there before I could say the rest of them. And APOC, he dropped off real quick, so we're going to see what's going to happen with that and find out. Next, we are moving to Defiant.
If you also want to go check out ZeroFrags.com, I know you're on www.e-rev.tv, so I don't have to say how cool that site is, of course. Just, you know, check out any of the events going on there, some of those custom maps for download on ZeroFrags, and, you know, give a shout-out to the community. Keep it tight because, you know, we gotta keep tight as a community, even though we are very competition-based because, you know, we all like the same game. We got to play with each other, so deal with it.
Yeah, we were just trying to get the server information because they changed off servers on us there real quick.
Oh, no.
So we're going to have that coming your way in just a little bit.
Oh, good game, Matchcoms. Technical difficulties, folks, just stay tuned. We'll be up and running here in just a moment.
Yes, we have Kitten, I believe, going behind the scenes to go get that server info for us. And we should have this match coming your way again in just a little bit. Again, this is TDM 44 TWL, Xeno defending the number one spot against the Chosen Ones. I mean, Piff, for that first map, what did you think?
It was all knock, man. I mean, it was their whole team. It was about even down the lane, but I mean, knock had just a phenomenal net at the end of that match. Really good use of the jump boots. Really good use of evasion. Smart choices. Don't fight six members of the other, or don't fight all four members of the other team when you can just get the hell out of there. You know, I mean, smart choices. Good placement on the shields. Good camping of the power ups. He wasn't really much on the double D because he was much more concerned with the shield and keeping his health up. I think at one point in time there, just from picking up miniature health vials, he was running like 170 or something like that in health, which is kind of a feat there. So it was really just map control and really team control, putting a triangulation of fire on those members of C1 as they came up as a group. If one of them saw one, they obviously were calling it out on Ventrilo or something like that, and saying, hey man, you got to back me up, you got to flank this guy. And that's what we saw happen over and over and over again. Another thing I noticed was just phenomenal control over rockets, of all things. I mean, he was just taking people out with rockets to the face left and right, and blind shot combos. Very impressive. And I saw a lot of that from the rest of the team, too. So, now C1, APOC, of course, you know, first killing spree of the map, obviously held it down, did extremely well, very accurate with his hit scan as usual. Not so much on his rockets this time, which was surprising to me. You know, doing a lot more spread rockets. Last time I saw a lot tighter spirals, a lot more direct hits with SD. But we'll see how it goes this next map. You know, as I said, the match is not over. You know, that's just one map. Right now, for the map, Nock is definitely our MVP, but we'll see how it goes at this point.
Well, we saw C1 last time here in EREV against Silent Dragons play Defiance. And again, like I said at the beginning of this cast, a complete annihilation and rape. I mean, breaking the 100 score and keeping them less than 20 frags against them. So, you know, we're going to definitely see a turnaround of this. This map, though, a little bit more open, a lot more room to move around than it did with Deck. So, I mean, you know, that's going to come into play here also. Both these clans, old school UT99 clans, and have come in here and made the move into UT3. So, we want to thank them for coming in here and bringing us this great action for everyone to check out. Real quick, I just want to say again, while we're waiting for the ready up, Warfare of the Nations next weekend, and also the weekend after that, check out www.e-rev.tv, and you'll find all the dates and times as far as when that match, as well as other matches such as COD2. We've got America's Army Division that has been created, so you're into America's Army. Guess what, guys? We've got the cast coming your way here real soon, so check us out in the forums. Or if your team has a match coming up and you want a request to be checked out, hit us up in the forums, put it in the broadcast request section. Hey, I just want to do a couple shout-outs here real quick. Shout-out from Fragged Chicken. Shout-out to Raise Your Brightness. We can't see anything. Again, that's something that we did mention there, and we want to thank you also for pointing it out. Nomad doing his first cast of this night, so we're still tweaking out a few bugs here and there. So hopefully this next map, though, is a much brighter map, and it will be okay for you. And now, so a shout-out from Kitten saying shout-out to Nomad for the video, and to Chachi and Pip, I love you guys, so thank you very much, Kit. All right, 1 second. It looks like we got a spectator slots we need to do. Let me see here real quick. Looks like they are missing one spectator slot, so we're going to try to get that in so Piff can get in.
Hey guys, we are missing a spectator slot.
Not fair, man. Can't have a match without my sexy butt.
Need to have three total. none of our guys can't get in.
Alright, so hopefully we'll get that underway. Let's see. Apox, add one right now for you, so
okay,
hold on.
Cool.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm no longer the unwanted stepchild. Well, I may be an unwanted stepchild, but at least not to them.
Again, this is Defiance. A lot brighter map, a lot more room to move around. So we're going to see a different play than we did in Deck. I mean, Deck, I like Deck, but in this version, it just seems so confined. I mean, it's always been a confining map, but in this version, it just seems even more confined. I mean, you get two guys standing side by side, the hallways were practically filled up. So, you know, we're going to see a lot more movement going around here, and we're going to see what really ends up happening with this game. And I see you did just connect. Is that true?
Yes, indeed. I just got in here.
And a shout-out from our video guy, Nomadicus, real quick. Shout-out to all his T5K clan mates. Gotta love guys over there at T5K. Good stuff. Shout-out also from Axis White Fang. Shout-out to all Axis Kicks ass. So White Fang wants to let everyone know his team is the Shiznapper.
Very nice. Having a little bit of trouble. A little technical difficulty. I'll get right back to that.
Alright, looks like we're waiting for one more person from C1 to come in here. And then we should go get this match underway. Well, like I said, UT3 community is bouncing up all over the place. There's several places you can check out if you want to get active in the community. For example, UnrealNA.com has been a pretty popular place for a lot of the DMers and TDMers to hit up. So if you want to go over there, you can hear lots of discussion about what's going on in the competitive world of DM, TDM, as well as I believe you got a few CTFers over there in the corner as well there that like to speak something. So if you want to get active in the community and you're into that game type for the U.S., check out UnrealNA.com. Like I mentioned earlier, for you Warfare players out there, the ones that want to be Warfare players and just want to see what's going on with the community, www.zerofrag.com. They also welcome all mappers into their community. That's right. A lot of custom Warfare maps have been coming out of the zerofrag.com community. A lot more you'll probably see placed on servers that you enjoy playing on. So if you want to check out what's going on in the Warfare, hit them up over there at www.zerofrag.com.
Yeah, and I want to hear some shout-outs from that VCTF community, by the way. I never hear shout-outs from those guys. They're just quiet now, you know? They were so active, the VCTF community in 2K4, and I don't see, you know, much right now. I want to hear some shout-outs. Anybody who's a VCTF player, their clan's going to do competition VCTF, give me a shout-out here.
And also, for those that are playing the gamer one, check it out. I believe Epic has slated for their next patch to be released sometime soon. Several nice fixes coming along the way that help with a little bit. Most of them look, you know, majority of server fixes. There are definitely some needed server fixes. Web admin finally is going to get put into play. Thank you for that, finally, because I think we were screened for that since the release. And we got a few little gameplay fixes here and there, so hopefully around the corner we will see that patch coming around the pipe. And we'll see a lot more games getting played.
Yeah, I'm really happy about that that admin thing. You know, that critical function of being able to ban the jackass on your team who obviously doesn't know what he's doing or who is intentionally running the orb out into the middle of the ocean. I'm sure everybody can relate to this. You know, that loving moment that you see your orb carrier run out into the middle of the sea or to the enemy base intentionally and drop the orb and do it over and over and over and over and over again. And so you just want to put your head through your monitor. And there's really a problem with not being able to ban those people. And I'm going to be really happy when that admin fix comes in. Also, I'm not particular to watching Helios bots go insane in the middle of a map trying to lock onto a target while I can't kick them out of the server. GG.
Oh, you gotta love those pub jackasses that you gotta deal with. But yes, I've been trying to get some so we can ban away your blasted CD keys and grids. Forget your ways that you try to work around. There will be no more.
I was ready to kill that guy, Chach. I swear to God, if I was in the same room as that kid, he'd be dead.
Well, the only killing that we're worried about right now is what's happening tonight. Again, if you're just joining us, it's Zeno versus the Chosen One. Zeno taking the first map by about 20 frags or so there. So, and that was Deck. And we are on the second map. This is Defiance. A lot bigger map, a lot more room to move around, and something that we have seen C1 play and dominate in. Now, whether or not they will be able to dominate this team like they did the last time we saw them play, that's going to be a whole other question. But, you know, so far, I don't know. It still looks like it's an even matchup, because you saw where in the first map, you know, where C1 did have the advantage. They were up, you know, 8 to 10 frags, you know, early in it. But then it just turned back around, and this team was just able to come back and beat them out by about 20 frags. So I guess, you know, showing why they're 6-1 right now.
Yeah, they definitely are, man. They definitely are. All about that map control, as usual. Map controlling. Teamwork.
Still waiting for, I believe, Nova to get in here. I think they said he was trying to set something up. And I don't know exactly what that is. But we're just waiting to ready up. Ben, are you still not in here spectating?
I think that's what he's trying to set up right now. Actually, I've been trying to get in for about 5 minutes now, but I think he's getting ready to set that up now.
A lot of times it helps out whenever we have these servers already set up ready to go. But yes, that's what they're doing. They set the slot just for you to come in here.
Is that live now?
No, they're still doing their thing, I think.
Okay.
We're willing to go to a quick video while we wait for this to start up. So if Nomad you will, let's do it. Again, for the team, you're going to have Paypot, Nova, Danimal, and Hillary Duff on the C1 side. Gino, again, you're going to have Nock, Osiris, Solidus, and Apostasy. So, same teams we had last time. We're going to see if it's going to come with the same outcome as the match is about to begin. Piff, are you ready?
Hey, Chip.
All right, Piff might not be ready. All right, well,
I'm ready up right now.
Oh, all right, there we go. Well, I'm going to start this out, and I'm going to look at Nova real quick, since he took the time to be able to get the spec slot in. Get a little camera time here real quick. He's holding with a shock rifle in hand, and he's jumping around trying to find some action. Hasn't really found anyone to play with yet. Looks straight ahead, and does try to throw a prediction coil there. Looks toward the double damage area, as there is a member of Zeno down there waiting for that pickup. Nova just trying to watch it. Drops down low towards the arm area, and the shocks fly back and forth as they both jump from each other. C1, or Zeno throwing out, and that was Apostasy with the shock combo, taking out Nova. Nova did get that armor, though, so at least he did keep the armor from coming in play. with Apostasy getting the kill off of him. I want to move on to Apostasy real quick. He's sitting with 30 health, has shock in hand, and he's going up the sniper lift towards the sniper rifle. Sniper is not there. Holding around, looks ahead, throws out the cores, and runs into a wall, though, with the cores. He's not able to connect. That member, C1, getting double-teamed with enforcers in hand. He's trying to avoid dying. Posse backing up because he's also at 10 health. As he goes out with enforcers, that was Apocalypse with an enforcer kill. What's up with you, Pip?
Taking a look at Danimal right now, throwing some spam down the hallway towards a member of Xenon. And looks like he was camping the Hunter Child a moment ago. Kill Solidus from behind, full flak blast, taking out another member right now. Looks like he's going to have another kill on his hands here. Yep, nails knock and goes for the 50 shield, evading that sniper rifle. Oh, it's tagged right there. But that 50 shield protecting mostly. Now with 5 health, actually going to get mowed down by the sniper, or mowed down by the stinger there. Respawns into a headshot by Hillary Duff on Xeno, and looks like he's just trying to take out some other members of this. Who are you watching right now?
I'm on Knock at the moment, actually, with a flat cannon. Just took note, well, with a flat cannon in hand, sitting with 108 health at the moment. As he goes up that sniper lift, again, looks for the double damage, and catches Hillary Duff with a full load of flak right to the face. I hope Hillary doesn't like to swallow that, because it hurt. It hurt like heck. Knock is up there at the top again. Another member of C1's over there camping the double damage area, and they're pretty much keeping an eye on that, making sure. Knock tossing his weapon out to that member of C1 to give him a little bit of ammo. So there you go, team player of Knock. Knock picks up a sniper rifle, has it in hand, holding up top. Score right now is 9-12, though. C1 does have the lead. We're going to move around and see what other action is going on. I'm on Danimal at the moment. Danimal holding flat cannon in hand as he's going over towards, was going towards rocket area, backs away, moves off his path there, is around the link, picks up that link gun, dropping down in front of the shock spawn, moves around, and he's trying to chase down a member. He saw a member C1, and the person is just not there anymore, but he is glowing and full of shield, apparently, because he's wanting to get some type of kill, and he's not finding any action at the moment. Apostasy, though, I'm on Apostasy now, who has found the action, and he also found Nova's rocket. Nova taking him out. Apostasy with Enforcer in hand, getting surrounded, pulls out that impact hammer, trying to get a splatter kill, tries to run the person down. That person's also running him down with Enforcers, and that was Apoc taking him out with Enforcers. Apostasy not able to get out of the spawn even before he could pick up the weapon. Now he is playing with the Enforcer. Lucifer has impact hammer in hand again, avoids the dude that comes after him. And he's so close to getting it, he just cannot tag that member of C1 as he's flying around the bio. And that was Nova with the bio taking him out. Turnaround so far, C1 22, Xeno 11. So C1 having a better chance this map right now than they did with Deck. But again, in Deck, we saw them take the early lead and lose it later on once Xeno got a feel for the map.
But, you know, Chach, here is where it gets tricky. This is definitely, definitely one of C1's best maps. They're good at camping the power-ups. They're good at actually getting that triangulation to fire on people in those larger open areas, doing the flanks on people, because there's so many different ways you can actually get into the main room or the double damage room in this actual map. There's about 6 different paths you can take to any of the shields. The only thing that's really in a, well, actually, to be quite honest, this map is it has horrible kill areas for all the shields. You're pretty much a dead man if you camp them too long because you're in a dead end half the time. But it looks like the 100 shield is back up, and it appears that C1's all over it. They're sticking together a lot better this map. You got 3 of them right by the 100 shield, one of them with the double damage. Looks like Hillary Duff's trying to take out a couple members of... excuse me, Xeno with a sniper rifle, and makes the wise choice, pops off a couple shots, and then escapes. Got, because he had 3 members up there, not a good idea to actually take that on in a TDM match. So I'm going to move on down to Solidus, see what's going on that side of the map, because right now C1 is kind of dominating this with a 29-17 lead, and Solidus actually using the stinger trying to mow down a member of C1 who's obviously shielded up. Apocalypse nails Solidus with the rockets. Apocalypse loves the rockets, of course, and he respawns right into an impact hammer from his own teammate, unfortunately. That's not going to help the score any. But comical as it may be, who are you checking out?
I'm looking at Nock at the moment. He's holding the Enforcers in hand. Picks up a little bit of health. Looks like he's waiting for some weapons to spawn. He was around the Rockets area. Rocket wasn't there for him. Looks like he's heading back over towards the Sniper area to see if a Sniper Rifle's there. Nothing's there for him either. So he finally drops down to the flat cannon and does get some weaponry. Drops down towards that 50 area. Finds a member of C1 down there. Rocket's in hand, but he gets double-teamed from behind as Nova with a shaft takes him out. So 34-17, we're going to watch C1 a little bit more here and see exactly what's going on. I'm going to get on APOC. APOC with a score right now of 13, he's got the high for his team. And he's holding around with 47 health at the moment. Shock in hand, throws out the cores, and with a hard combo next to the Apostasy, takes the Apostasy out, looks out towards that 100 area, and he's trying to kill off that member of C1 before that 100 does fall, but he has to back out with only 22 health. He really can't stand there and go toe-to-toe with him right now, as the Stinger was chasing him down.
Making a wise decision there, escaping when he could have given the other team a kill. You see that a lot from Apocalypse. You also see that a lot from Hillary Duff. She'd much rather jump back and actually lay the hit scan on him than stay there and get killed by half the team. The double damage is up, and Apocalypse was on his way there but got hit with a nasty combo from below. Do you see who's actually on that right now, Chach?
I do. That is Danimal. Danimal now has the double damage. He's holding down around the 50 health, 50 armor. Moves out towards Shock Spawn there into that area. And he hasn't really been able to find anyone. But he gets taken out with a very hard combo from Nock. So the double damage did drop from his possession. And Nock picked it back up. Nock, with hand, takes Hillary Duff out with a Shock Beam. Run around. The double damage is about to run out. He picks up the helmet, takes out APOC before that double damage runs out, so gets himself another kill, takes out Nova and starts his killing spree with a Shock Beam. Picks up a little bit more health. He's at the sniper left, goes up, picks up that sniper rifle, and he's probably assuming that double damage is going to come up very soon as he's holding around that double damage area and is just looking out to see if anything can happen. Moves out there, Danimal in front of him. Danimal going out with a Shock Beam in the face. Nock is just tearing it up right now. 106 health at the moment.
Really picking up his game. I mean, anybody who's watching, you know, look at what he's doing. Look at what he's doing. He's stacking the small health power-ups. He's making sure he's staying at 100. He's stacking his shields whenever he can. He's trying to not get flanked, which just happened there, and got nailed by Apocalypse, which tends to happen every about 3 seconds in this map, no matter who's playing. But still, he's doing what he needs to do, and it unfortunately is not really helping that much, because C1 still is in a commanding lead of this map. 14 kills up, 31-46. Current scores are Apocalypse 16, Hillary Duff 13, Nova 11, Danimal 7. Then Osiris has 11 on the Xeno side, Nock second with 9, Apostasy with 6, and Solidus with 5. Right now, Nock running with the Enforcers, trying to take out a member of C1. Two members of his team come up and manage to destroy that guy. And he's going for the thigh pads right now to pick up that 30 shield, because that can be the matter of, you know, matter of life and death right there. Another team member, however, ganks it from him. He's now doing rocket spam back and forth with a member of C1. Hillary Duff's killing spree got ended by Apostasy. Took her out before she could take down Nock. He really needs to get out some health pickups quickly, or he's just going to give them, whoa, blind rockets from around the corner and take out Apocalypse. Then Nock comes right up on his respawn, but gets nailed with the Enforcer from the side by Hillary Duff. Vengeance for that blind kill a moment ago. What are you looking at right now, Chach?
I'm looking at Hillary Duff at the moment. Hillary Duff is around the sniper area and takes some damage from behind. I don't even think she knew where that came from. She gets down to 35 health. Enforcer's hand goes out to a headshot from the Enforcers, a hold ahead from the Enforcers. So Hillary Duff now has a Stinger in hand. It's moving around. It's going out towards, going out towards the Shock at the moment. Going to see if the Shock there. She didn't bother checking the Shock. She's content with the Stinger at the moment. As starts to run the Stinger against a member of Xeno, but that was Nock with a flat cannon. Now, Nock has been good, but Xeno has been good of keeping the spread from being too far. They've kind of held at this 14 spread as far as the frag count goes, but they haven't really been able to gain any ground. As soon as they get a kill, C1 gets a kill right afterwards. So, you know, they're really going to have to move forward and get some extra kills. Stop just trading off back and forth if they want to catch up with this.
At this rate, it looks like they're picking up one here and there. I think really, because right now it's sitting at 11 different, 12 different. So I mean, there are 11 different, or 10 difference now. So I mean, they're picking up one here and there. If they can consistently do that and keep up with these power-ups and keep stacking that health and be very, very mindful of their surroundings, as in don't get flanked by 12 guys, I really think that they could turn this around. But keep in mind, you know, I mean, this really is C1's map. I mean, they pretty much own this map from what I've seen them play before. But it can still go either way. It is early enough in the match, and it's only a 10 lead now. They've actually taken it down to almost single digits.
Osiris just picked up that 100 shield, so he's sitting with 110 health and at least 100 shield. Picks up the thought pad, so there's another 30 for him. Starts to run the shaft right now as he's chasing down that member of C1. With a link gun, run the shaft, takes the Danimal out. Osiris is still trying to do the link train thing, but he is starting to get surrounded. But he's somehow backing out of it with 85 health at the moment. Runs forward with the Stinger, but not enough as he goes out to the flat can of Danimal. So was able to get something there a little bit. Now, Zeno has caught up just a little bit. It's just a 9-kill deficit. We've still got lots of time, 8 minutes left in this match, so the map is far from taken from C1, and they're going to still have to stay up on their game at the moment. We're going to get on APOC real quick. He just took out Apostasy with some rockets. He's only sitting with 11 health at the moment, so he's going to have to find out where he can get some health at. As he's checking around down there where those 50s, that 50s are not there. But he's still sitting with 111 health, but no one has touched him yet. Throwing out the rockets, takes Apostasy out, still avoiding any damage at all so far, so you know, definitely a plus for him. Still a 9-point difference with C1 in the lead. Keeps checking that 50 health to see if he can get anything from it. And he does. It takes Knockout and it takes the double damage from Knock. So with rockets in hand, picks up Sniper Rifle, has Shock in hand at the moment, pulls the rockets back out, and he's hoping he can catch somebody as he's finally starting to get some health. He's up to 81. He worked himself out of that. Very good job from him avoiding the damage as the double damage gets run out. Picks up some shock ammo and he starts spamming the rockets again. He did see a member of Zeno in front of him. And he's going around the corner to see if he can chase that person down. Picks up the Stinger from anyone that might want to have it. And starts running against that member. And, you know, it's just, he got lucky there, but he's down 32 health, down to 11. Can he do it again? He's running the Stinger, running the Enforcer, I think he pulled out for a moment. No, that was the Stinger, just the secondary fire. And I don't know, doing good so far, but they are slowly disintegrating that deficit. 10 kill difference right now.
Yeah, like I said before, man, they're inching it up a little bit at a time. They had it down to 7-kill difference a moment ago. They just lost one. It looks like Apostasy actually took himself out by accident. That's unfortunate because in a close map like this, it's critical that you cannot make those mistakes, especially at this point in time. You've only got 6 minutes left. You know, you're counting down the clock. Obviously, C1 knows this map. Obviously, they're really kind of controlling the power-ups. You only got like 10, you know, you got 10 kills to go, and you got to just keep it close. Now, the double D's been picked up by, looks like C1 again. Really not a good thing for Zeno at this point. And Nova's got it. What are you looking at, Chach?
I'm looking at Osiris at the moment. He drops down towards that 50 area and wasn't there for him. He takes a lot of flak from Danimal as Danimal takes him out. It's 60-70 right now. C1 does have the lead, 10-point advantage at the moment. 5 minutes left into the map. And Osiris is running around with dual enforcers in hand, 120 health. And he's checking out the 100 shield. 100 is not there. That shield belt is not there to be had. Goes up top. No one there to fight. So, I mean, a blessing in disguise, seeing as he only has those enforcers, but it looks like he's content with just kind of holding those out and waiting for that shield belt. And finally, though, he pulls out the link. He does have another weapon. Pulls the shaft out, tries to put it against the side of the head of Apostasy, but Apostasy taking him out by accident there. So it's the team kill thing is a little bit off here.
it's really costing them some critical points. I mean, like I said, you know, at this point in the game, you got 4 minutes 30 seconds left. You've got to make every single one count. You can't let them get stacked up like that. C1 will just eat you alive if you let them do that, especially in this map. Right now, Cyrus is sitting at 16 health, just got taken out by Apocalypse's Shock Beam. Nasty with that. Basically, running around with his rockets, getting the 30 shield pads, trying to take out another member of C1 with the rockets. Actually, C1 not looking too good, taking out the Enforcers, but I've seen some Enforcer kills that were pretty interesting tonight. Hillary Duff takes a hard rocket to the face. Cyrus nails her, grabs the flat cannon, moves around to the 100 shield, actually decides against it, goes for the health power-ups, and starts dueling another member of C1 with the sniper rifle. He's got the rockets, though, tossing them out, and tries to flank. Now, I think he's going to go down to actually check that shield, but nope, I'm wrong. He's getting caught by a sniper fire from the right-hand side, and now looks like he's going to try and take out this member of C1 with just some around the corner. Yep, Osiris nailed Apocalypse. Should have known that was Apocalypse. A lot of double dodging with the actual sniper rifle. So picks up the helmet and moves on to pick his health back up to 90. Get back up to the sniper area, pick that up, make sure and control it. Obviously, Apocalypse has a favoritism to that weapon. Now, Osiris has the double damage. He's positioned extremely well to pick up points right now with that sniper rifle. Takes out a member of C1, going for another one, trying to get the flank action on him. Really needs to stay away from him. Oh, well, that ended that pretty quickly. Gets taken out by a shot combo. Are you seeing what I'm seeing, Chach?
I am, but I'm also looking at Apocalypse, as he just did a double kill. Got Osiris and Solidus there with that. So I'm looking at Apocalypse, sitting with 93 health at the moment, with rockets in hand. And he sees a member of Xeno in front of him, tries to do some connection action. Both of them dancing with rockets at the moment. That person is also starting to get flanked, and that was Solidus. Solidus taken out from Apoc's rockets. Apoc at 65 health at the moment, moves forward and gets himself back to 100 health very quickly. With Stinger a hand at the moment, and goes back to the rockets. Looks like weapon of choice. As he checks out that 100 shield belt, 100 shield is down there, and I believe someone did grab that already. Ryze accidentally clicked off.
And Apocalypse now on a killing spree, pretty common there for him. So basically, running down by the 50 shield, picks that up, only sitting at 41 health right now. Really just trying to see what he's got going on, but it doesn't look like a whole lot of action in his direction right now. Might be able to get a flying shot combo or a rocket on that. Yep, nails knocked with that rocket. Man, that was a good snapshot there. Actually dueling another member of Xeno right now, and coming down to the 50 shield again, spamming some rockets to keep somebody from pursuing him. Now, gets the flank on Xeno. Looks like he took out Apostasy. Got two members rolling up now, though, but we've got 3-on-2 with C1 being the preference right there in that middle area where that 50 shield is. Now he's got some flak action, trying to get caught with some... blind combos, but Apostasy takes out Apocalypse. And now see what's going on with him. Actually, I'm going to look at Solidus, because really we haven't spent a whole lot of time on him this map. He's spamming some rockets around the corners, trying to get that 100 shield. The pickup is not there yet. Actually following and backing up another member of his team. Good thing, because somebody came around the corner with the 100 shield from C1 and tried to take him out with an Enforcer of all things. Looks like they're going to go down right now, though, with rockets, but I don't know. It looks like he's missing a little bit there. So Solidus trying desperately to... take off Nova, but he gets picked off by Osiris with a sniper rifle. Now,
I gotta
flat
say,
cannon
we are
on
in
Daniel.
The last 40 seconds real quick, man. Last 40 seconds of the map, and a 9-point deficit. C1 is up at the moment, and they're going to have to do something Xeno's going to have to do something very quickly if they want to have this happen. 30 seconds left. Tying it up. Doesn't look like you're going to. Looks like C1 will lock this in hand. I'm looking at Nova for this last little run of it as he's got this sniper rifle in hand and just trying to get some sniper shots out. Barely missing with a couple of those shots. He's getting very close, but just not good enough as the goo comes out of Knock and takes him out of the game. The last 10-second rundown, and C1 taking the second map, so we will go to a third one. That will be Fearless. Fearless will be the third map we're going into. Score, final score, 99 for C1, 87 for Xeno. So definitely a third map and a good come around for C1.
Yeah, definitely. Apocalypse, definitely the MVP on this map. I think that was the same case when they faced SD. You're looking at pretty good scores across the board for Xeno, actually. But really, like I said before, I mean, this is really one of their favorite maps, C1, that is, and they just controlled it very well. Obviously, you know, worked together pretty good. Obviously, you know, got their power-ups like they need to, camped their shields like they need to. Really, that's what I expect to see from C1 a lot of times. And I think that was the opposite in that first map. I really think that Xeno has a great preference towards Deck, obviously, because of their use of the jump boots and how well they actually controlled that double damage power-up, controlled that 100 shield. That's very obvious to me. You know, but same thing happened there, you know, just a minute ago with C1. I mean, that's what I'm seeing anyways.
Well, and back at Deck, we saw Xeno where he covered, or excuse me, not he, but for example, Nock. A lot of times you saw them around the double elevator lifts down there, holding around the bottom and then coming back and forth to check for those double jump boots. So, I mean, you saw that happening a lot in that map, but with that map being such a much more confined map, it was really kind of harder to hold out without dying. But again, Xeno did it very well. Lots of great escapes using the jump boots. Now, in this particular map we just played, Defiance, I mean, a lot more space, and it looks like that was really C1's preference in playing with the space. So we're going to see what happens when we go to another cramped map and see exactly how this fares.
Agreed.
Looks like the teams are having a little dispute over the map, or not a dispute, just don't really feel like playing Fearless, which I can't blame them. It's a very cramped map. It's very easy to get, well, team kills on this map because you don't know what the heck you're firing at half the time. I think they're going to end up playing... What are they actually looking at, Chaz? Can you tell?
Oh, well, I saw someone mentioning Shang, so we might see Shang alive. Real quick, again, if you're just checking in with us, we are on the last map of this TWL 44 TDM match. This is Clan Xeno UT versus the Chosen Ones. Xeno defending their number one spot with the current rank of standing at 6-1, while Chosen Ones at 1-1. But you know what? Just because they've only got two matches there, doesn't do their skill justice, because they showed after getting beat by about 20 frags or so on the first map, which was Deck, they came back and got a nice 15 frag lead on Defiance. So coming around to start this third map, and originally was scheduled to be Fearless, but it looks like they are trying to figure out if that's exactly what they want to play or not.
Slight technical difficulty, I believe. There was a little disconnect there because of the map vote. We'll be getting back in just 1 second.
All right, quick shout out from Deb. A shout out to Piff. He would like to have your man children.
If you have
any shout-outs, hit us up on GameSearch, #E-Rev for your shout-outs. I'm E-Rev-UT Chachi. We've got E-Rev-UT Piff in here. And we can get those shout-outs for you as we get this last map ready to go. And we are having to reconnect the server because they changed the map off there.
Just bear with us one moment, folks. We'll be up and running again in just a second.
All right, yes, they did finally choose for Shang CE. So Shangri-La, but the changed around version for some frame rates and things like that. Never. Again, if you're looking out for some matches coming your way, if your team plays in UT3 or COD4 or America's Army or TF2, we've got tons of cast games to cast here at EREP. If you want to get your team's match broadcasted, check us out in the forums, register there, and put in broadcast request, and we can try to get those pulled out to you. Well, both these Greens teams agreed to change from Fearless to Shangri-La CE version, so I guess they're aware of all the changes that will happen with that map, and they're okay with it. Again, this is another one that we saw C1 play Silent Dragons and get a significant, like I think it was 120-something to 20 win. So definitely a map that obviously they love and they enjoy playing. I mentioned earlier we saw great power-up control coming from them during that map. So, you know, we should be here on the way real soon.
Looks like there's a little bit of an issue with the map. I think they're going to revote because of the changes that actually took place with no double D, no damage amp and whatnot in the 1v1 version. So.
All right, there, and that was one of the things that a couple people mentioned in IRC. They're one of the teams to do that. I've got a couple of shout-outs real quick. One shout-out from Wicked Tech saying that the UT3 TDM Cup starts Sunday. Get your teams ready at IRC on irc.gamerays.org. Pound UT3 TDM. Pickup up games are happening daily over there, so be sure to go out there and check that out. So I want to thank Tech for bringing that to everyone's attention. Also, another shout-out from Axis White Fang saying Chachi and Piff are sexy beasts.
Thank you very much, but I'm spoken for.
And I'm actually having to reload my game. X-Fire crashed it out.
GG, X-Fire.
Not like we have pro comps in their colon slash.
Yay, ready up. Trying to play?
On a side note, I have a brand new rig coming my way on Monday, so you should see me playing in the pubs a lot more.
Yeah.
So if you kill me in pubs now from now on, I can't complain about frame rape. It's just me naturally sucking. That's why I shout instead of compete.
See, you know, I have so few joys in life, and one of those is you know, making fun of you about your frame rape comments, and you take it from me. Why do you take that from me, Josh? Why do you do that to me?
Because you're just that damn good.
I hate you, Josh. Display it. I think we're getting ready to start up here in just a minute. It looks like they're still in the warm-up round. I think they've decided to ready up, and it looks like we're going to go live in 3 seconds here. First one I'm starting on is actually going to be Nova, who starts out right at the rockets, gets the first kill of the map with Solidus, looking to pick up those jump boots. I don't know if he's going to camp those out. Looks like he is going to wait for them to come up and moves down to the link area in the right-hand tunnels, jumps up the lift, goes to the top level, looks like he's still coming back to try and get that shield, but he gets flanked there by another member of Xeno, but teams up with one of his C1 guys in the meantime. Now, who are you looking at, Chops, right now? Because I don't see if I have... Oh, never mind. Nova's actually taking out somebody with rockets, doing a little bit of spam back and forth, but between him and Xeno, he's got another team member flanking him on the other side. Pulls out the link, starts link taping him, trying to get that kill. Gets taken out by Osiris's green shaft. Speaking of Osiris, do you see where he's at right now, Chops?
Actually, I am reloading back into it, so you keep going there.
Gotcha. Osiris actually got him right now. He's moving around to the link rifle, or link gun, link taping one of the members of C1 through the hallway into the main room on top of the bridge. Now it's down to a dual enforcer at point blank. It's taken out by Nova, and Nova does, or Osiris does too, so it was both of them got killed. Osiris nails the double damage. Actually, the first pickup of the map, very, very critical to get that map control and get that first pickup. Now, keep in mind, that Hunter Shield's up now, too. I didn't see who got it, but, you know, whoever it is obviously going to lose that now. Now, Osiris actually trying to spam some Link around the corner, take out the member C1. I think the member C1 actually wised up and ran off. Nope, looks like he got flanked by another member of, excuse me, Xeno, and the double damage is running out right now for Osiris. Now, it doesn't seem like either team has really got the advantage here right now. It's 6-6 across the board. It's Nock with the top score on Xeno, of course, you know, and Apocalypse with the top score on C1, which is to be expected a lot of times. But the scores are pretty daggone close across the board, except for Apostasy with a -1. I think he actually had a little mistake there right at the beginning, which can happen from time to time in DM, obviously. Now, Osiris is still in the main room. Looks like he's trying to camp out that double D and make sure that stays on the Xeno side. Nova gets hit with a Nox Plasma in the another part of the map off camera. I'm going to move on to another member real quick. Now we're looking at Hillary Duff from the C1 team taking some sniper rifle fire and actually getting tagged around the corner. Looks like she's trying to camp out those power-ups like she usually does, get those jump boots and actually move up to the 50 shield. And there's the jump boots, there's the action from her, hitting with the rockets, takes out one of the members of Xeno, and Hillary Duff also kills Osiris then with the rockets around the corner. Now, Nox killing spree got ended by Solidus there, which, you know, is a good thing because Nox is going to go to town on you if you don't to control him and get those power-ups away from him. Hillary Duff moving back to the main room, actually picking up some rocket ammunition. And, John, what you got looking at right there?
Well, Solidus did have a double damage, but he just got taken out. So I'm now on Hillary Duff, who has it, but it did run out. She took out Apostasy before it ran out. Link on your hand, looking down towards that shock area there, and takes Solidus out. But from behind, she gets taken off by Nock. I believe that was a sniper rifle shot from behind coming from Nock. Right now, scores are 7 for Nock, 3 for Osiris, Solidus 2, Apostasy 0. Apocalypse has 4, Hilary Duff 4, Nova 4, and Danimal 3. Its scores are 15-12 with C1 with a slight lead at the moment.
Hilary Duff, she just made some people ride her green shaft. I didn't realize she was post-op.
I'm on Apocalypse, and Apocalypse just got taken out from Apostasy. So not very long for him to show off. He picks up the Stinger, though, moves ahead towards that flak area. No flak to be had. Moves over towards rockets. No rockets to be had. As it goes up that elevator lift and look towards the 100 shield, but avoids a sniper shot of a member of Xeno. Starts landing that Stinger against him, and that person did back away. So Apocalypse has now moved away from the 100 shield. Does get some rockets, has rocket in hand, moving ahead, finds a member C1, and that was Solidus taking two very hard rockets from Apocalypse. So Apocalypse getting a kill in there. Score 16-12 though, and with C1 with a very slight advantage, but definitely far away. But we have lost a member of C1. So
actually we lost a member of Xeno.
Out.
Lost a member of Xeno. He's back now. I believe he was just having some issues with his comp. Nope, he's down again. So it looks like that C1 has the advantage right now. I mean, they're down a player on the Xeno team. Really not a good thing to have happen in a match. Not a lot they can do about it, though, unless they want to dispute later on in TWL. I don't see any call-outs from either team saying, hey, can we hold up for a second? Of course, I mean, really, with the time just ticking away, it doesn't really help. But right now, I'm looking at Hillary Duff actually running around with a bio rifle. Hopefully, we'll get knocked back in here pretty soon. But she ran around with a bio rifle in the main area, I believe, camping that double D, trying to get it. With a bio full spam at the door. Good place to put that, actually. It's a blind shot, and if you come around the door, you'll run right into it, get a decent kill like 2 minutes down the road. She's got a full goose shot loaded up, and she's going back into the main room across from the Stinger, and actually going back and forth trying to camp those spawn areas of Xeno. Now, with a flat cannon in those hallways, it's really easy to kill yourself, so she actually bolts from that really death trap, picks up the jump boots, hits the 50 shield, as she always does, because that's how she loops, and then goes and gets about 5 or 6 health power-ups, moving her up to 125. Now, Flak getting some stinger fire from the from another member of Xeno down in the main hallway there while casting some flak down at him. Picks up the sniper rifle. Here's where she really shines with that sniper rifle in that main room. We saw some really impressive stuff from her with SD last week, or a few weeks ago, actually. Now, she's back in the rocket room with the jump boots, actually, kind of getting out of there real quick, spamming some trip rocks down, and gets taken out by a shotgun before, but she can really be effective right there. Now, who are you looking at right now, Chach?
I'm looking at Solidus at the moment. He's just holding Enforcers, and he goes out to the Stinger of Apocalypse. Posse off camera takes some, another member out with a Stinger. Since Knock has dropped, the change isn't really big significant. Actually, they've kind of gained a couple of frags. But the score is 20-26 right now. C1 does have the lead. Solidus getting shafted from behind, so we're going to watch it as he goes out. Hillary Duff with a shaft. Scary woman with a shaft. Solidus still running around, picks up the sniper rifle, looks out towards that double damage area, jumps on top of it, so he does have a double with sniper in hand. I believe that is the only weapon he has in hand next to the Enforcers. And he gets taken out. So, you know, Apostasy now with Enforcers in hand running the double damage as he goes out to Nova. 0.130 is the score at the moment. I mean, it was just going back and forth with this double damage for a while.
That was actually quite funny. One person had it, got an Enforcer killed. Next person had it, got another Enforcer kill. They got killed. Then Xeno comes up and hits somebody with a full goo, kills Hillary Duff. It changes hands again. So five people had one double D. You usually don't see that in a competition match. Usually the double D carrier runs a train on the other team for a few minutes.
Well, right now I'm checking out Knock. He's the back. I just want to say that, yes.
Loading up full goo, running across the right-hand side up towards the sniper rifle. Spamming rockets down that hallway, trying to avoid the link fire of another member of C1. Getting the shock rifle and picking up some ammunition to go with that. In the main room now, picking up one of the power-ups, trying to get some action and flank one of the members of C1, but getting sniped from behind. Hopefully that doesn't connect very well. Now, another member, Gene, joined up with him, just spawned right next to him, but they look like they've got different missions right now. Throws three rocks into the main room. Looks like they're trying for some blind kills with some random rockets, which is a good strategy, actually. You can pick up a lot of points that way. Apostasy off camera gets carved up by Apocalypse's green shaft. Now, Nog is actually running some combos down from the main part of the room, getting link taped by one member of C1. Nails Apocalypse with a shock combo, hard combo to the face, taking some shock primary from across the map, counters with shock primary, sniper rifle fire coming in at Knock right now. He actually decides to bolt, which is the good decision when it's only sitting at 83. One sniper rifle shot and a single bullet from the Enforcer would take him down. And then a blind combo around the corner doesn't really do him much good. Who are you looking at right now, Chach?
I'm looking at Novus. He's holding around that sniper rifle area, waiting for that to pop up. Xeno has made this deficit just a little bit smaller. Instead of being down 10, they're down 7. So they're slowly inching away at it. We still have 10 minutes left in this match. So still anyone's game. Nova, with a Stinger in hand, is moving around and starts running the Stingers down to 58 or 59 health and goes up top. I think he accidentally got knocked into that lift, and it was a good thing for him. He picks up another 50 health. He's running around with Singer hand still, checking out that pickup spur, that armor spawn, but nothing's there. Looks across the way, he's running the Stinger at the Stinger spawn against that member of Xeno. That member firing back with shot. Nova down to 4 health, needs to be careful, but it was Knock with a flat cannon to take Nova out. So, not a lot of love coming from Knock. We're going to get on, let's see here. We'll get on Apocalypse real quick, as he did just take out... possibly Solidus taken out with a double kill, but not coming up with the finish off with the flat cannon. Apocalypse right now score 15. Hillary Duff with 11. Nova with 10. Danimal with 4. C1 on the blue team. Red team Xeno. You got Cyrus with 9. Solidus with 9. Apostasy with 5. Knock with 4. I'm still on Apocalypse as he takes knockout with the rockets. Weapon of choice, it seems like, most of the time with this game. As he's loading those up one after another, he's firing down into that pit to see if he can catch any damage on anyone. But it looks like everyone's kind of cleared the way, so it's not a whole lot to go with. Moves in the main room towards that Stinger spawn, throws that rocket towards the shot, and he's just, again, he's loading up rocket after rocket after rocket, trying to catch somebody around the corner. But you know, it's not going to happen to because he gets taken out.
Yeah, unfortunately, that was a team kill, it looked like, so it's going to cost him a point there. Picks up the bio rifle and starts going after another member of Xeno, taking some stinger fire, and actually loses to that stinger fire from the knock. Looks like they're kind of going back and forth trading blows right now. I think they're kind of looking for each other, knowing that they're two of the dominating forces on these teams, and trying to take each other out, as you would, obviously. Right now, Apocalypse is basically camping where the health area is, outside of the 100 shield spawn. Actually catching some double damage fire from a shot primary from the member of Xeno. Actually running with a stinger, taking some enforcer fire from two different members. He really needs to bolt right now, but he doesn't get out of there quick enough, can't make that jump, and gets taken out by Xeno. Now, that spawn was actually quite good. He's got three members on one member of Xeno. Apocalypse takes out Osiris and tosses that stinger to his teammate. Teammate runs off, though, misses it entirely, picks it back up, gets that ammo, got to keep it, and looks like they're running to the rocket area. I'm going to move down to Apostasy, see what he's got going on the red team. He's pulling up he's pulling up the back end of the team right now with only 6 kills, but we'll see if we can turn that around, because they really need to pick up still 10 kills now to actually, close this up and make it real certain that they're going to be competitive towards the end here within the last 7 minutes. That's what we got remaining right now. Hard combo in the face from Nova, actually takes Apostasy out. Blind combo around the corner actually was quite good, and then he spawns back into the main room. Now, current scores are Apocalypse 17, Hillary Duff 14, Nova 14, and Danimal 8. That's C1 current scores, 53 total. Now, the Xeno current score is 42 total, with Nock at 10, Osiris at 10, Solidus at 10, and Apostasy at 6. Now, you can see that Nock has really, really picked up his game. He came back in just a moment ago. He's already 11 kills. So we'll see if that has some, relevance in actually turning this map around for them. He does seem to be their, number one player from what I can see. What do you think about that, Josh?
Alright, well, you're right. He's come in there. He had lost a few points, so the true score isn't reflected, but he has already come in to take the lead. For his team. I'm actually on Hillary Duff at the moment, because I love cute little blondes. But Hillary Duff with flag cannon in hands, moving out there, and that member of C1 getting surrounded, that was Nova that got the final kill with it. But Hillary Duff, using the jump boots, goes up, picks up that 50, and goes up there, also picks up the health, gets up to 96 health, and still with flag in hand, now with sniper, and shows she's not afraid to pull out the hit scan and try to hit the snipe shots. Not able to connect, though, because there were two members of Xeno across and hasn't been able to really hit with any of those shots. So, again, she's not afraid to try, but at the moment, she's not connecting with a whole lot. So we'll see how that works out later on.
It's really surprising for Hillary, because she was actually quite good with hit scan.
It is very surprising. She did a really good job the last time we saw her play some map using that, and it just wasn't working out to her advantage. I moved over, though, and I'm on Nova at the moment, who had just got taken out. Some enforcer in hand, no weapon, still waiting to pick something up. And, it's kind of funny how UT3 actually has a weapon to start with that people don't mind using at the beginning of a match. Tries to pick up rockets with Apostasy with the rocket kill of himself, right as Nova stepped on the rocket spawn. And I thought I heard someone pick up the double damage. Let me see, I'm looking around to see if that did happen. And I'm not seeing anyone with it. It may have been a double damage running out that I heard.
Not really sure what you heard there, man. I didn't actually hear the power up go down. I'm looking at Apocalypse right now. Just got purple, got some black there. Picks up the helmet. Goes for some shock core ammunition, picks up the shock rifle, taking out one member of Xeno, who's spamming him with the stinger. Apocalypse nails Solidus with a combo in the corner there. Double kill on Apostasy. Son coming up the right-hand side over the bridge, throws a combo up there. Loving the combos right now, it looks like. Of course, he's probably not holding the rocket, but ends up getting nailed by Nox flat cannon. He really comes out of nowhere with that, and I've seen him take out APOC like that about 6 times now, it looks like. APOC coming back to the main room, sees the double D. Can he get it to it fast enough? He's racing another member to that, and it looks like he actually does make it there. So Apoc with the double D, firing stinger shells at another member of Xeno. Looks like he turned his back on him. Not a real wise decision there, but managed to luck out and get away from him with the and not get taken out by the shock primary. Double D is still up. Hillary Duff, this cost him a point, ended up killing herself. Looks like then Xeno's actually at 51, C1 at 65. Current scores, Apoc 21, Nova 18, Hillary Duff 16, Daniel 10. And then on the Xeno side, Nock 14, Osiris 12, Solidus 12, and Apostasy 7. They're really not picking up much ground here, Chachi. They're 15 down now. They were only 10 a moment ago. It seems like C1's picking up some speed here. I don't know if they weren't warmed up the first map, or if their ping difference was just too bad, or something like that. But obviously, we're seeing a much more typical, you know, like, basically performance from C1 right now, especially from Apocalypse, you know, leading the team, really getting some critical kills, and some double kills, and some killing sprees and stuff like that. Who are you looking at now, Chach?
I'm actually looking at Osiris at the moment with rockets in hand, trying to avoid getting hit from rockets himself as he's running, picks up another 40 health. He's over there by that 100 shield, moves away from that, and starts to move towards the main room to see if he can find the action. I mean, he goes the double damage, has double amp in hand, and changes to the Enforcer. Pulls out, and now he does have a Stinger gun, so it looks like he's going to try to have fun with that Stinger and see if he can run down a few players. Goes into the main room. And starts running his shots and can't find anyone to really shoot at. Finally does find another member, but double rockets from behind. Hillary Duff taking that. And I believe she also did pick up the double damage. That is true. She does have double damage and has the flat cannon in hand. Hillary Duff with 100 health at the moment. She's sitting by the jump boots, picks up the jump boots. I guess, yes, she does. Moves up to the 50 area, but the 50 armor is not in place. Picks up another 25, 35 health, makes herself up to 140 health. There's the 50 armor she was looking for, so she is sitting really pretty on the health right now. And now has that shock rifle out in hand, moves over towards that shock doorway, and looks straight ahead in the main room. She's not able to connect with the shots, though. She's just barely missing with each one of these shots. Nock has started a rampage off camera. Osiris finally getting a kill, Hillary Duff finally getting a kill on Osiris. There we go, not going out to the shot of Hillary Duff with the sniper rifle. She's sitting with 190 health, and there is the 50 amp again. So she's even hurting herself just so she can take full advantage of it. So
it's
picks
a classic
it up
DM
sitting
move.
With, sitting there with tons of health at the moment. Tons of shield, moves out into the main room. And just kind of holding the edge. We're going to look off because we're on the last minute. Piff, why don't you take us away for the last minute of this?
You know, 50 seconds counting down, 61 to 76. C1 leading a commanding lead. Even if we still had some time left, hard to catch up. Apostasy taking some combos from around the corner. Gets nailed from Danimal's shot combo. Danimal gets carved up by Nox Green Shaft in the meantime. Now Apostasy's taking sniper rifle fire from Nova and gets hit by the shock primary. 30 seconds left. 78-62, 79-62. I think they're going to push it over the 80 mark. Might have a 20 kill lead by the end, which would be very actually quite common for C1. I really think that they warmed up, they got their game faces on after that first loss, really started concentrating and just took them apart. That's what I'm seeing here, man. Awesome maps, 5 seconds left, and the final score on this, it looks like it's definitely going to be C1 with the win, unless Xeno actually disputes this because they had Nock drop out, which I believe they could do actually on the TWL ladders. 82 to 64, final score on that, C1 with the victory, that and the match goes to them. And I got to say, Apocalypse, once again, second cast in a row, MVP of all of the maps.
I would have to say that too. I mean, Apoc, not the dog, the rest of their team. I mean, for one thing, I've never understood why most guys play under a girl's name, Hillary Duff being a guy, obviously. But I guess it's just that
humiliating
factor. Yes, the humiliation factor. But, I mean, that team all stayed very close for the majority of it in most of the maps, especially that last one. You're going to hear some people say, oh, well, you know, Xeno lost due to Nock dropping out early in the map, which very well could be a possibility, but we also do have to look at the one true fact that we do have, that even after he joined, C1 was able to make that lead larger and larger. So that will definitely, got to give props out to them because they are the new number one spot holder in the TWO 44 TDM ladder. Quick rundown on deck, you had Zeno winning by about 20 frags or so, but then we moved off into Defiance. Defiance, you saw the Chosen Ones come back and turn around with about a 15 frag lead, and then finally that last map, as you just saw, which initially was supposed to be Fearless, they decided to play Shangri-La, and it worked out into C1's advantage. Them taking the last map and the match, I want to say a big congrats out to the Chosen Ones for that, and also big props out to Zeno for requesting this to be casted. I've got a couple shout-outs real quick. A shout-out to the Damage Amplifier from Fragged Chicken. It's got to love the damage. And let me see here. Shout out to Devil of Zeno. He only sucks your balls. That's coming from Tech, you bench warmer.
Feel the love, everyone. We just love everyone in the community. That's just awesome. Hey, Chach, do you have anybody on a post-game interview here? Can we get APOC and maybe Knock in here?
I think we're running just a little bit long, so we're going to have to cut this short, unfortunately, here. But we want to thank everyone for checking out tonight's cast. Also, be sure you check out www.e-rev.tv, as well as hit us up on our IRC channel, #e-rev on Game Search. If you got any match requests or any games that you want to see played, hit us up in the forums. We've got a lot of cool stuff going on in there. We've given away a couple of free servers lately, so we've got some more promotions and contests that may be coming around the corner, as well as several other games you can check out broadcast for. Piff, you got anything else before we roll out here?
Yeah, absolutely, guys. Everybody keep an ear out. They've got the tournament next week with the UK versus the US. If you want to get in on that action, at least come to the practices, work out some strats, support the team, support the community. I think Dow's actually participating heavily in that. Get in touch with Thunder, maybe. This is not directly from him, but I'm sure, they would appreciate the support, as I'm going to help him out with that, definitely, and BGE is going to help out with that. Also, keep in mind that TDM tournament starts next week. I believe Chach called out the information earlier. If you want to get that again, just go back to earlier
correction
in the cast, rewatch it.
Correction real quick, I'll go ahead and say that actually starts tomorrow. It's the UT3 TDM Cup starts Sunday, and check them out on IRC, irc.gamerays.org, #UT3 TDM.
Thank you, Chachi. Definitely, man. So check that out if you're interested. And you know what? That's it for us. Great maps tonight. Great competition. Could be a dispute on there. A little drama with that because Knock dropped out. But overall, really good maps. And this is Piff signing off.
Forget the dispute. Give me a rematch. I want to thank Nomadicus for doing a video breaking his cherry for the first time tonight. And that will be it. So for EREV.TV, Chach, Piff, Nomadicus, we want to thank you for checking us out. We'll see you next time. Peace.
In a time where video games were competitive and casting companies were few, gamers searched in the dark for their hero. One name, one company came to save the day. Instant Replay, War Room Ventrilo, and unforgettable voices were heard over the airwaves. Electronic Revolution Broadcasting Network rolled onto the scene. Often imitated, but never duplicated. EREV, gaming enhanced.